Okay, radishes, done. What's next? I think I'll do spinach. Yeah, I just happen to have these in my hand. Yeah, I planned on doing spinach today. I just said that. But I pulled out all the radishes, and I'm still eating radishes. Oh, by the way, thank you, everybody, for all the comments in the last episode. I appreciate it. Oh. I was supposed to go fishing today, but we have a 75 to 80% chance of thunderstorms, and I don't like to fish in a thunderstorm. I'm funny that way. So I thought, well, what am I going to do? Well, I'll come out in the garden and I'll plant my spinach, because it's going to rain anyway, and the garden needs some rain, so I might as well get the seeds in the ground, and then the rain can take care of it, and I don't have to deal with it. So I pulled all the radishes out, cut all the tops off, threw them in the compost pile, and the potatoes, I trimmed those up, and I thought, well, might as well do some spinach. And generally, spinach is an early season. I know some people are thinking that right now. See, I can read your mind. A lot of people are thinking, well, spinach is an early season crop. You can't be planting that right now. Well, I know, but I didn't have spinach in the early season. Otherwise, I would have planted spinach. And I was going through my box when it was time to plant the seeds, and I thought I had spinach. I could have swore I had spinach. So maybe some kind of a garden gnome snuck into my seed box and stole my spinach seeds. Don't know. So I planted extra radishes and I didn't plant any spinach. Mike picked me up a couple things of radish seeds at Walmart. Thank you, Mike. And because he loves spinach. I mean, it's fun. It's great stuff. It's easy to grow. It's delicious. It has more nutrition than lettuce. So it's a good alternative for lettuce. I actually grow spinach in place of lettuce a lot of the times. And because spinach is really, really delicious. It has more texture, more flavor. It's a wonderful thing. You can cook it. Whereas lettuce isn't really much of a cooking type of thing, and you can eat it raw, so it's a very versatile thing. And all it wants from you is water, cool temperatures, and lots of nitrogen, and I got plenty of those. But what's going to happen now is we're going into the warm season, and in the warm season, when it gets hot, what spinach and other leafy crops want to do is they want to bolt. And if you don't know what bolting is, it's a really horrible, horrible thing for us gardeners. What it'll do is it'll send up a stalk, and it tends to get smaller, more pointy leaves, and it tries to put out a flower head, a seed head, because it wants to actually produce seeds. That's what they all want to do. And what it does is it makes its leaves more bitter. And I don't know why it does this. I'm thinking, okay, Ray, think like a spinach. If I want to survive and put out seeds and stuff like that, I'm going to probably want to make myself less tasty. And I'm thinking like a spinach. And so I'm going to make my leaves all bitter and everything, so everybody's going to pass me by and go on to something else. And then I have the opportunity to put out my seeds. That's my take on it. Probably wrong. I don't care. But spinach does not grow well in hot seasons. So I'm going to try to grow the spinach in a hot season. And since this experiment worked so well for the radishes with the shading, you know, in the afternoon, it worked like a charm. I'm going to try that with spinach. I'm going to push my luck. I'm going to see if I can grow spinach in the heat of the summer in Iowa. Theoretically, I shouldn't be able to. All the experts and all the information points to no. And I've never been able to do it. I tried it in Minnesota and I couldn't do it in Minnesota. So I'm going to try it right now. Let's go and plant some spinach, shall we? One thing I want to make sure I do before planting seeds is take any green material that's laying on the soil, take that out of there. Because if it gets mixed into the soil, like that one just was, if it gets mixed underneath the soil, what it's going to do is it's going to bark and run across the yard, apparently. Well, what it's going to do is borrow some of the nitrogen from the soil. When you bury green stuff, it takes nitrogen from the soil to help this to decompose. That's just how the world works. I have no control over it, but that's not what we want. Eventually, once it decomposes, it gives the nutrients back to the soil. So it's just a borrowing thing. But I don't need that while I'm trying to grow spinach, because spinach is going to need all the nitrogen it can possibly get. So we're going to toss this off to the side, take the soil, declump any kind of clumps that formed from the soil being just left alone, mix it with my hand or whatever tool you may have at hand. And I'm gonna grow, let's see, do I wanna grow two rows? Yeah, what the heck, oh, whoa. Holy Moses. Not what you want to come jumping out of your soil when you're trying to do your soil. For those of you who are a bit squeamish, this thing's a lot bigger than it looks. Yeah, he came running right out of the soil. Oh, that's not pretty. No. He's not any kind of weird, harmful spider to me. I mean, it's not like a brown recluse or anything, but still. Okay, back to our garden of terror. First thing I want to do is get a little row, and I've got all kinds of insects in here. You name it, I've got them in here. I'm going to do two rows, and that way they have a little bit of room for the roots. Spinach and lettuces don't really have a lot of need for deep or wide roots. I mean, they will put out decent roots, but they can be clustered up together. They do really well. You know what I'm going to do? This is how I'm going to do it. Very simple. Do one trench and then another. So I'll take half the seeds into my hand. I know, I tend to overplant these, but then again, better to overplant than underplant. And then just take the seeds, sprinkle them in there. Just like this. No special spacing or anything like that. I don't do that. I just never have been a fan of that. There are devices that do that and stuff, but no. I'm just a little old-fashioned. Okay, take that. Throw the soil over. Bury it about a half an inch deep. That sounds about right. I don't really measure that either. And then I do another trench right over here to the edge. Then I take the second half. I don't know what are these called? Bloomsdale. Hey, there's a, look what I found. That's a tick. Yeah, I got ticks in my garden. No, I don't think so. Yeah, these are just regular common ticks. I just take them, snap their little heads off, back to the soil they go. Well, sorry to be so rough, but you know what? I like to keep my blood in my body. Yeah, I'm a little old fashioned there too. Anyway, the last bit of seeds. Oh, this is a lot of seeds. I don't get it. That's usually you open up a package of seeds and you're wondering, why did they bother wasting all this packaging on just a few seeds? This brand, Burpee, I guess Burpee, yeah. Boy, they put a lot of them in there. Thank you, Burpee. I appreciate that. Okay, now I'm going to just, normally I don't press it down that hard, but I want to make sure it's not too high up in the raised bed. But. And what I would do normally is give this a very light watering to wet the soil. But I'm not going to do that because we have a 75% chance of scattered thunderstorms today. I don't want to be watering my garden right before a thunderstorm. That would be stupid, and I try to be stupid as little as possible. Okay, done deal. Yeah, I know, rocket science. But that's how I plant my spinach. That's actually how I plant all my seeds in my garden. So now we play the waiting game. Well, now all we can do is cross our fingers and wait for the spinach. Okay. All right. It's probably going to take a little bit longer than this. Okay, so we'll keep an eye on this. We'll keep an eye on this, and I'll let you know how it does. And, while I got you here. All right. Now, by the way, the type of spinach that I planted was called Bloomsdale Longstanding Spinach. Well, the other kind is called Baby Leaf Hybrid. And I thought, baby leaf hybrid? Why would I want spinach with itty-bitty leaves? I know it's supposed to be more tender and stuff, but I don't really notice a difference between little leaves of spinach and big leaves. They're all the same to me. And little leaves are such a pain to deal with because you got to pull the stem off of them. I'd rather have the big leaves and pull the stem off of them. So I don't know why I would even want to use this stuff, but Bloomsdale Longstanding Spinach, that's supposed to stay a little bit longer. So I'm going to hope for that. The other stuff, don't know what I'm going to do with it. Maybe I'll scatter them into the asparagus beds or something like that. I'll feed them to the chickens. But anyway, spinach is done. But while I have you here, I want to show you what's going on with carrots. I'm going to go see what's going on with the carrots myself. But when I grow carrots, and I wanted to make sure that I go over as many things in the garden as I can through the entire season. And pardon me if I'm touching myself a lot. I normally don't do that. But there are mosquitoes out here. Yeah, I know, but what I won't do for you guys. I'm getting bit by mosquitoes, but yeah, what can you do? When I grow carrots, I incorporate a lot of compost. I dig the soil really deep, and that's how I grow my carrots. You're not supposed to put in a whole lot of organic matter. People will tell you, well, that's what they told me when I looked at it online when I was doing this a long time ago. I read that you're not supposed to put a lot of organic matter in there because it causes your carrots to fork or do all kinds of funky stuff. You know, you've seen all those weird shaped carrots. Well, I didn't much care for that advice, so I didn't take it. And I grew carrots 1 year up in Minnesota, and I mentioned this episode a lot because it was my one of my funnest episodes ever. I harvested carrots, and I gave my actual reaction to the carrots I was pulling up. These were two-handers. I literally had to use both hands to pull these monstrosities out of the soil, and it just freaked me out. I had a wheelbarrow full of carrots, and I ate those things for so long, I was sick to death of carrots. There is a point when you can eat so many carrots that you want to kill yourself, and I reached that point, and then I ate a little bit beyond that. But yeah, those were called Nantes, scarlet Nantes carrots. They're only supposed to get like 7 or 8 inches long, and mine got like a foot. Yeah, and you think that, you know, foot-long carrots are going to taste crappy because they're just way oversized. No. They were tender, they were delicious, and they were everything that you'd want in a carrot. And when you're picking a carrot, when I was picking those carrots, the smell came out of the soil, and it was just the most amazing carrot smell that you don't get from store-bought carrots. So they were absolutely perfect, and I was amazed. So ever since then, I've been promoting lots of compost, water them deep, just like you do everything else, and dig the soil deep loose. That is the key. You have to have loose soil, because when a carrot hits something hard or it can't push through, it'll start going all funky, and that's where you get all the strange looking carrots. So I have about maybe a foot and a half worth of soil in there, and the carrots should push down really, really easy with that coir and that compost. Let's go take a look at those carrots and see how they're doing. Okay, ooh, weeds. Hiding, are we? Well, you can't hide for long. You guys gotta go. Yep, this garden is for me, not for you. Okay, weeds are gone. Let's look at the carrots. They're looking pretty good. Yeah, I know, they're really, really clustered together. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna pick a couple at random. Ooh, these look like a couple good ones that are close together. And maybe one right over here. That way we get a good sampling. These are looking beautiful. Yeah, we're not going to get huge carrots. That's not what the point of this was. The point of this was to see how the carrots are growing. And the carrots are growing absolutely fantastic. Look, we have a long root, and of course, that's what we want. We want the root to be going straight down and to be long. We don't want it all clustered together or all warped. What that's going to show us, if it's all bent, is that the soil is a little bit hard and we're going to have problems with our carrots. Early carrot growth is going to show us how our carrots are going to grow in the future. And this is perfect. It's got the little hair roots right here. That's what they're supposed to have, but it has that long taproot going down. These are doing really good. They're right on schedule. Whether or not we're going to have full-grown huge carrots at the end, that's up to nature and the spin of the wheel. But for right now, they're looking really good. Not bad, huh? Yeah, they're doing pretty good so far. Don't know how they're going to end up. I don't worry about stuff like that. I don't stress out over my garden. I just figure, well, today they're doing good, and that's the best I can do. Today. Tomorrow, who knows? You know, the world may not even be here tomorrow, but you know what? Today's a good day. I got good growing carrots. Ooh, you know what? I don't have the water hose here, so pardon me while I eat a dirty carrot. I tell you what. There's a lot of good flavors coming out of a garden, but very few can match the flavor of a fresh carrot. Oh, the smell just fills your whole mouth with carrot smell. Oh, you gotta love it, you know? I can see, I'm not a vegan, not a vegetarian at all, but you know what? I definitely see the allure of vegetables in a diet, you know? It's just the difference in flavors. You know, meat is one thing. Meat has a flavor and stuff like that, but vegetables, it's like the symphony, you know? A tomato has its own distinct smell and flavor that can't be duplicated by any other vegetable. Parsley, I got parsley growing here, and cilantro, you know? I come out here for the smells and the sights and the sounds and stuff of the garden, and they all have their different textures, their different flavors, their different smells. It's beautiful. It is absolutely beautiful. But enough of me ranting and raving about nonsense like that. But I just wanted to bring this to your attention. This is how we grow carrots. So throughout the season, I'm going to show you how they're doing. Don't know if they're going to work out, but let's hope they do. If they do, I got a heck of a growing system for growing carrots, and I'm going to promote that. If I don't, well, I have a heck of a lesson to teach you. But anyway, our spinach is growing. Our carrots are doing fine. Everything's doing wonderful. Look at the dill. That stuff is huge. I don't know what I'm going to use it for, but for right now, it's just fun to do this. So it's paying for itself. That's it. That's it. Just a short episode to plan a few things and to say hi. And thank you, everybody, for tuning in. I'm glad you guys enjoyed that little gift, that the goats and the rascal. It was fun filming that. I enjoyed the heck out of that. And also for all your comments on last week's video. And by the way, thank you, everybody, for the fan funding. Again, thank you so much. I appreciate that. Everybody, you're just great. You're just great. And you make my day just that much better. This is a genuine smile on my face. Okay, I got to get going. I'm going to head inside. It's going to rain. And I don't want to spend that money on a brand new camera. No, I don't want to do that. Thank you, everybody. Oh, by the way, you know what? I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to buy me a new microphone. Because I had to cut out. You know, I was doing last week's episode. And I'm sitting on that box. You saw me do the exit, you know, the last part of the video. That wasn't the original. The original was so much better. You know, and I was sitting there, I was talking, I was having a good time. Rascal is jumping up on my lap. Everything was going fine. You didn't see any of that because I had to clip that out because I went inside and I uploaded from the camera onto the computer and it was static. I don't know why. I just bought this ridiculous microphone to go on to this wireless setup here, and it's supposed to work fine, but it's not. So I am so sick to death. It's not even a cheap microphone. This thing is not a cheap microphone, and it shouldn't be doing that. So I thought, nope, gonna go shopping for a new microphone. So that's what I'm gonna have to do, and that way I don't have to lose any kind of footage, and I don't have to do anything subpar. You know, I don't want to do without a microphone, and I don't want to have a cheap one. I want to have a nice one because I want the communication to go just fine. And well, hey, look, hi, you're wet. Okay, thank you, everybody. I'm done. Rascal's done. We're gonna head inside. I'll talk to you all soon. Have a great day. Bye. Hey, wet dog, wanna go inside? Of course you do. Can you hear that bird going nuts in the background? That's the sound of a robin having a really, really bad morning. I'm trying to film this episode and Robin's going nuts. I thought, well, what's wrong with you? Why are you doing this? I'm trying to do something here. And then I realized, as soon as I turned off the camera, so I turned it back on, look at why Mrs. Robin is losing her mind. Because she has a nest right up there in that tree overhanging the fenced area. And look at what I found hiding out. Little Special K. Yeah, the little kitty. You've asked me, hey, how are the cats? Well, I don't see them that often because they're out hunting mice and rabbits and whatever else cats do. But every now and then I see them. This is what they do. Well, little K's taking a nap right on top of the shed.